Hey, what's up everyone? I hope you are all doing well. In the last video, we covered Gigabyte PerfDrive feature, which packs 5 different profiles between Intel's default baseline and performance. Then we have Gigabyte on overclocking mode, Spec enhance, optimization, and unleash. We saw the possible gains, which in maximum scenarios got me 7,000 points increase in Cinebench R23 multicore by using Intel Core Ultra 7 265K. And we saw how they differentiate from voltage to clock ratio, temperature, power limits, and power consumption. But then, when I was looking through BIOS, I stumbled upon something interesting. In PerfDrive, when you choose any of Spec Enhance, Optimization, and Unleash, it unlocks two additional options that are grayed out by selecting Intel default profiles. These options are CPU upgrade, which can be switched between default and max performance. And this adjusts the turbo ratio by +1. I think we talked about this in the previous video, but what we didn't talk about is this one called Enhanced Multicore Performance, which gets unlocked when you select those 3 presets. You can switch it between enabled and disabled. And as it says here, what it will do is setting the highest turbo ratio to all CPU cores. So we'll experiment with both options to learn how they can affect performance. Before I forget, the motherboard I'm using is AORUS Z890 Elite XIs, updated to the latest BIOS version. I'm using version F10D, which is the latest as of making this video. Things may change over time, so I'll try my best to update if I notice a significant change. And now, before we get started, I'd like to give a mention to this video's sponsor, MoniMaster. MoniMaster is a specialized parental control app designed to monitor your children's phones closely. Let's say you are worried someone may abusing their kind heart. This app serves in situations where you can decide to let your child use a phone completely, but still worried about them going online and wanted to be under your supervision. MoniMaster is currently doing a Christmas and end of year sales with up to 62% savings. They offer tailored services like monitoring specific apps like WhatsApp or Facebook, status tracking, and even PCs. They also offer special bundles, including combo services for extra savings. To use the discount, just copy the code above and paste it upon purchase. Once you have an account, even before installing it on the target phone, be it Android or iOS, you can do a whole demo of the service. As you can see, the main view is of this dashboard where you can get lots of information on the go. And on the left-hand side, we have a menu full of options, such as checking call logs, messages, Gmail, contact, blocked contact, etc. You can even check screen time to know which apps they are using the most and for how long in a very interactive graphical manner. And you can also check social media texts, images, and do live screen monitoring. It's a total comprehensive tool, taking it to the next level to protect your loved children from any internet harm, with over 1.5 million satisfied users, according to them. I'm personally not a parent, but I can imagine how worried parents can be for their children, and hopefully this service may be of help from any harm to them. Thanks for MoniMaster for sponsoring this video. Alright, now back to our video's topic. So what we are about to do is Cinebench benchmark. Here on the left, we have a Spec Enhanced mode set in PerfDrive with CPU upgrade set to default and enhanced multicore performance to off. Then, in the middle setup, we have CPU upgrade set to default with enhanced multicore performance option turned on. Then finally on the right, we have the opposite. CPU upgrade set to max performance with enhanced multicore performance set off, in order to see the behavior we can get in each setup. And here are the results. For both options off, we have 36,325 for multicore and 2,139 for single core. Then when we enable enhanced multicore performance mode, we get a similar multicore score but reduced single core one. Then with CPU upgrade set to max performance, we get a slightly higher multicore score and a bit better single core one than when we have enhanced multicore performance enabled. Now checking the gathered statistics, with both off, our max core feed is 1.291 volt, while it's 1.236 volt with enhanced multicore performance on, and finally 1.281 volt with CPU upgrade set to max performance. Now this is where it gets more interesting. When we have both off, our max P-core reached 5.5 GHz, while it's 5.2 GHz with enhanced multicore performance mode on and gets to 5.3 GHz with CPU upgrade set to max performance. I'm not sure why it's doing this. I would expect those options to boost core clock rather than reduce it. But if we look further, with both off and with enhanced multi-core performance mode on, our E-core is 4.6 GHz at max, while it gets 4.7 GHz with CPU upgrade set to max performance, which is why earlier we got a higher multi-core score in Cinebench. As for temps, it's 74 degrees for when we had them both disabled and even when we had enhanced multi-core performance on, while it got to 80 degrees with CPU upgrade set to max performance. All of them share the same PL1 and PL2 at 4095 watts, which means infinite. And max power draw is 217 watts for both disabled, 218 watts with enhanced multi-core performance mode on, and finally 240 watts with CPU upgrade set to max performance. So if we analyze this, we can understand that each of these two options makes some influence to some extent. Now I also wanted to enable both enhanced multi-core performance and set CPU upgrade to max performance in all three different perf modes to see which is the best. So we'll try them on Spec Enhance, Optimization, and Unleash. For scores, they are almost the same, 37,000 for multi-core and 2,000 for single-core. So in theory, compared to Intel default performance, we had a higher boosting clock for P-core, which is why we had a higher single-core score compared to this. It has been reduced by around 100 when we use those presets compared to Intel default performance. Let's check now the statistics we got. For Core VAID, Spec Enhance has 1.2 79 volt or max voltage, Optimization 1.3 26 volt, and finally Unleash has 1.3 24 volt. All of them have a max P core of 5.3 GHz and for E cores 4.7. But if we look at the max temp, it's 78 degrees for Spec Enhance, while for Optimization and Unleash it's a bit higher, around 6 degrees Celsius more. All of them have equal PL1 and PL2 at 4095 watts and max power draw is 238 watts for Spec Enhance, while it's 255 for Optimization and Unleash modes. Now I'm not sure if something isn't working well with those presets or if they need some fixes, because we didn't get any score boost with Optimization and Unleash over Spec Enhance, yet they got higher temps and power draw. They may be in need of some tuning. So in conclusion, Gigabyte PerfDrive is an interesting feature that automates CPU boosting capabilities. You may need to experiment with them to find your best mode, but keep in mind that Intel's default performance mode, for example, has higher P-core clock potential, around 200 MHz compared to Gigabyte modes, but Gigabyte ones boost E-core by 100 MHz instead. I hope this video was useful. Please let me know in the comments below what you think, which mode you may go with, or if you prefer setting your own manual settings. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to TechOSOR to stay updated with all new content. I have many things to experiment with on this CPU and motherboard combo, and I hope you'll find them useful. Thanks for watching and see you guys in the next one. Peace out.